Good afternoon, one and all, respected jurors and mentors. Myself, Siva Krishna, and she, Juhi Bhowal. We are from Manipal University, Karnataka.
You will need to come here, can't see.
Yeah, assisted living center. Basically, the village, back to the roots, is our the theme name, the conceptual name which we have kept. Mainly, the assisted living is basically, it's for the elder people, the who are physically disabled, or the people who need assistance in their life. Like, it's mainly meant for them. So, we did a literature online case study, which is Springsbrook, which is in USA. So here, this is basically surrounded by jungle, it's surrounded in the jungle, and then with a complete nature, green spaces. So when we gone to the case study, I mean in the on literature, we have find the spaces which they have is, they have four different types of blocks, which is, they have four different types of blocks, apartment type 1 and type 2, and then studio apartment and the 2 BHK apartment. They gone basically into the vertical level, and then they have the multiple stories, and then they segregated the four different blocks. And then the main spaces which you have found is the fitness room and the open spaces, which is acts for the interaction spaces, and the common dining area, and then activity area, and then the lobby, bedroom, pool. Pool basically they're using for the therapy units, and then yoga spaces. So these are the major spaces which we found in the literature case study. And then
the site we have chosen is in Kolkata Rajarhat area, because Rajarhat is a developing area which is a developing now in a mixed use development. And in Kolkata, most of the people, like for example 65 to 70% of the younger generation are either staying outside or are always busy in workforce. So their aged parents are always stayed away in the home, and they feel lonely and they don't have anyone to look after them. So I have taken the site in Kolkata, which is like the site is in Action Area 2, and it's surrounded by the residential area and the greenery. The greenery is a Neem Banani, that project done by Hoodco. So the site is like is near to, near the Charnock Hospital, that is 6 km away from it, and the site has a well connectivity through road, rail, and airport. So
if we observe, here, the main thing is that's what the young people like in the Kolkata, mostly 65 to 75% of the people, they're searching for the jobs and they're leaving this place, and then they're leaving their parents in the home. So basically they are left alone. So like once the people become old, like they feel like spend time with their kids, like that is the main feeling which they get. But the thing is they are missing their things in their olden days. So and then they need a space for the provision. So that's the main criteria, like we choose the site there also, it's the main, like we choose the city because of that reason. And then the space provision, the design concept will be based on that. The back to the roots which we are telling is, we are bringing them to the olden days. It's like in a modern way. So that is what the main concept is.
So the site area is 3.37 acres, that is 13,600 square meter roughly. The site is has three road on three sides, and the south of the site this road connects to the Rajarhat main road. So this is the probably the best location for the site main entry, and then these roads are the 9.5 meter width road that surrounds the site which goes to the residential area. So we are giving the service entry from the this side roads. Now the major wind direction in the site that we have found is southwest to northeast, and the minor winds come from the northeast to northwest. And this minor wind comes because like more it comes more because of the presence of the pool and the neem, like neem tree. As you all know, that neem tree has a cooling effect, and the south site is will be affected by sounds of the car and vehicle traveling. So this part of the site will be affected by the sounds. So the zoning that we have done later on, we have considered the sound aspect as well. The side views, like view one, that is we are taking from the junction of the site. Then we go to the side view two, that is we are taking from the other corner of the site. View three, that comes like we see how the site looks from this area, like the main entrance area. Then view four is the that is towards the site, that what all are there. And view five is the back from the turning behind that what kind of like residences and all. Rightly it is a developing area, so residences are not there. And view six is the rear side that we take, like that we get the fencing. We can see that the that neem banani that they have kept. The topography of the site you have seen is almost flat, and the setback according to the Kolkata bylaws that we have taken is 5 meters all around. The climate of Kolkata is hot and humid, so and it has a very high temperature range and in summer and low in winter. So in this condition, like we did the site planning in such a way that the building is mutually shaded, and then we have used the local material like that is brick, which is very famous there. But we have used the hollow brick so that the air inside the bricks can insulate the temperature from outside. And again, if you see the humidity level in Kolkata, it all like range from 66% to 83%, which says that we need to have a cross ventilation throughout. And the rainfall in Kolkata is like for 4 months it rains nearly 1700 mm. So we can use the rainwater for recharging as well as the rainwater harvesting. And we use the low cost material not only because they are easy to maintain and locally available, but also to bring that the vernacular nature character of the Kolkata, like the old Kolkata that was. Nowadays we don't see it. It's all building.
Yeah, coming to the zoning. So mainly when we start zoning, first the initial zoning is to segregate the spaces. Like we have the private spaces and the public spaces. So what we did is, like initially we have segregated the spaces, like private spaces towards this corner and the public spaces towards this corner, and then the intermediate spaces like green spaces and the water bodies, like which acts as an interaction point. So then second, we change the zoning like step by step. By knowing the mistakes here, what is happening is, here the negative points are like when we segregated the zoning, private spaces like this. Here the main thing which we have a plus point is the pond, like which which can have a view to the user, like to get the feeling. So here what is happening is, half of the units are getting towards the roadside, which they are getting the noise disturbance, and half and they are not getting the view. Then what we have done is, we shifted the private units towards the pond side, and then the public units towards the road side, which people access and then easily can go out, and then service area and the service next to the service road. Then finally we have come up with the zoning is this is our second zoning. Finally we have come up with the zoning is, we have segregated that private spaces in between the water body. Here what is happening is, here we, as we told, micro winds are coming from the pond area, and then from the center, like instead of giving the view to only the private units, it's giving for the whole people, is like an enlarging the view is like more comfortable. So then we have divided the blocks to the corners, and then we are given a water body here. So when the micro winds coming here, so again there is a water body, so the cooling actually increases more. So then again, in the whole central portion, this whole central portion is given for dedicated for the interaction spaces, like the green spaces and then prayer area. There is a prayer area with a lotus pond. It's given in the center of the complete site, and then the complete large green interaction space for the people. And then there is a set of this set of portion is for the public spaces. And again, there is a pocket of interaction spaces is given in the corner, and a water body, which helps for the cross ventilation of the air, which flows through the site, complete site. So this is what about the zoning. Then concept, as I told, back to the roots. Like they came from the past, so they know now the society and everything is changing. They miss so many things. So they need to regain all the things at the similar way. It should be like contemporary. Like we need to develop also further. So then the thing is, we have taken the design guidelines, like which has to be there in the design, and it's completely ground structure, and the whole site is barrier free design. So then we have taken the cross ventilation, the diffuse sunlight, and then we use the local materials which is available for the energy like cost efficiency, the terracotta roof tile, and then the hollow brick, and then like solar energy like saving, and then the open spaces like the pockets, in the intermediate pockets, which give them to come and interact, and then interaction. And then this is the area programming like which is given to us. The total built up area is coming to 2960 square meters, which consists of the public spaces, patient spaces, support spaces, services, and other toilets and the multipurpose hall. Then coming to the site plan.
This is the site plan. So the main entry is given to, towards the southwest of the site. So this is where we enter, we drop off, this is the drop off porch, and then we exit. So if we want to go for the parking, we can go here. We have provided 10 car park and then 25 two wheeler parking. And the amphitheater we have provided at the entrance, so that the, you know, the amphitheater can be used for some kind of workshop to know, like knowledge, gain knowledge to the people, elderly, and to conduct some kind of maybe function, that is like local function, the like patients who are staying there, they can come and they can have a view and they can enjoy the space. And even for the people like who are surrounding, like the local residences, they also should come up, know like what is actually happening and what is this idea all about. So this kind of programs can happen in this open amphitheater. Then we go to the reception. So reception, from the reception we see that there is, like, we have divided the zone as told before, that we have done it in axis wise. So we have checked with like the sound and all other waste sun and all these things. So the west part of the site we have given for the public zoning, like the people, like so that the here, like the sound that can get affected. This will be like more of consultation area, therapy rooms, and the ICU. So where like more of the patients are not coming here. So the patient space are kept on the east side of the site, so that they get a proper view to the pond and the neem garden. And then they are they have a like connective, in between connective spaces, they have a swimming pool where the therapies like water therapy, then water aerobics, that they do for the more maintaining of the health for the elderly, that can happen. And then they have this connection between, like, we have what we have thought is, like, we are given 30 units that we have to design, but then it was written that 10 units. But we thought that we won't divide the physically like handicapped people, the disabled people separate. So we have divided the units in 5-5. So we have given male quarters and female quarters, which are being connected through this intermediate space. They have a water swimming pool over here, and they have a connective garden, like it's a there where they can interact, where they can play like the things they used to, they have seen from their childhood, that kind of space. So in this whole thing, the like visiting area, the center visiting area, this area acts as a visiting area as well as a focal point for the whole area. So over here, people who are coming from outside, they can also come and visit the patients over here. And this then they can lead to three different directions. So one to the prayer hall, one to the private residence, and another to the public areas. So, and then the service road we have kept on this road, and the services like generated yard, then wet and dry waste and laundry, and then gray water system. The water has to separate when three tanks, like how the system is done, that we have shown here. And then this is the HTP that we have provided, and the area over here we have kept it for future development, so that in future if they can come up with some other kind of ideas or number of units, they can come over here. And these are the views. So if we see this, the aerial view one is taken above the reception. The view one is from the amphitheater. View two is towards the reception. Now view three is from the reception towards the Buddha statue. There is a Buddha statue. As we all know that Buddha is a symbol of peace and serenity. So, you know, these people love, like, these people are someone who love all this peace and serene spaces. And then this Buddha statue, like the, this line, whole line of axis, like this get connected to the prayer over here. This is the prayer hall where we are, like where we'll be showing. So this, like, all over the corridor, this corridor, so that this is like more of an interaction. The patients can use this corridors as for walking also, maybe evening walk or a morning walk. They can feel, because the every day it will be changing. We have a flower garden over here, and these are the lotus pond, like just lotus and fish pond that is surrounding the temple, that we always see, like, a temple is consisting with a water body to connect that feeling. So, and this water body we see, this is basically because of recharging the wheels. We are not giving a particular recharge pit, but we are giving a water body, so that during rain, this can help, like, the effect. So, and then we're going to here, like, we have a kitchen over here that is connected to the service road. We have a general store and a normal store. We have provided a multi-purpose space. The multi-purpose space can be used for, again, for some activities. Like group activities where they active, like work, and then they have a common dining, and they have this swimming pool over here. So coming to the plan, and as you enter, this is the reception, this is the library, this is, we have provided one meditation room. This is meditation room is different from the prayer room. The people who want to keep themselves separate and away, they want to meditate, they can come in this room. And then this side of the wing, we keep the pharmacy and the administration block and the general store for the reception to keep the records. And then as we continue through this corridor, we get a toilet facilities over here for male and female, and as well as physically handicapped. And this part we have seen the these two are the four are consultation room. This is the lab. This is a physiotherapy room. And then these are water storage and the water cooling area. So from this corridor, when you see, these are the therapy and meeting rooms, and they have a courtyard, and this is the staff dining area. So staff dining has a more, like, both open and semi-open spaces, and these two are the staff residence. We have kept the ICUs over here and the caretakers unit over here, so that in case of an emergency, the care can be taken properly, like these people should be nearer. And even the caretaker unit has been kept near to this inpatient block also, so that in any emergency on call, they can go and see. So the kitchen comes here. The kitchen is connected with the common dining area. Now common dining area has a fountain pond. Now we know the water, the sound of water really feels like, we feel like so peacefully with sound of water. So over here, people can, while dining or after that or evening time, they can come, they can sit here. And this area is surrounded with trees. So even evening, we'll get some kind of shadow pattern over here. So if we see the unit type that we have taken, because as I told that we are not segregating it, so we have taken the standards, and then we have taken a circular radius of 1.5 meter, and we have shown that how the people, like physically wheelchair person, is working. To get the feeling of that old vernacular architecture, we have used wooden rafters and the terracotta tiles, and then we have used the cement and the brick, like exposed brick work, because this is something that is related to the old age. Like there we will use mud plaster instead of cement plaster. So somewhere later in the walls also, they can decorate their wall with the pictures or a motif that they want to. It's up to them. And then in the roofing also, we have that skylight tiles that we are placing, so that the light from the roof will come during the daytime in the living, like this living and kitchen area, so that the area gets lighted up. And again, like as this wall, we don't have the full, like walls are ending at 3.1 meter. So when a person is sleeping here, they can also see the sky. So that's how I have connected with the outside nature. And then we have used, instead of using like a cloth curtain, we have used bamboo curtains, which is again little nature comes to it. The views, now I'll be explain the view. One is from the reception towards the visiting area. View two towards, like from here, is the visiting area. View three, like from visiting area towards the prayer hall. And then view four goes from this area towards the living quarters. Then view five, again towards puja area. We come here and take puja. View six towards the consultation room, like as we see from the public spaces how it looks. And then view seven is the common hall.
And then finally, we have calculated the solar energy use, how much it is, and then the water requirement and the storage and the grey water use.
And so what we did is, because we are using the solar energy, according in Kolkata, we can give a perfect like angle of 22 degree to 27.5 degree. So we have used 27 degree for the photovoltaic cell to catch the maximum light. And we have, and even if we take a 25% of efficiency for those cells to harness energy, we will be getting per day nearly 112 kilowatt hour, which is enough to lit the landscape area at day and night, and even to lit all the rooms. For water requirement storage, we have seen like taken some standards, and then we have seen like how much water is required, and we have provided a 3000 liter tank for like daily. And then gray water, like we have taken how much flushing water we are using, how much is kitchen water. So we have taken, after calculation, we are getting the gray water is like 1500 liter that every day it can generate. So if we reuse it, we can use for the landscaping purpose. Rainwater harvesting, from the like data, amount of data we got, we can give a 500 liter rainwater tank to each individual units. It's not like whole, each individual units who can use the water. And the economic aspect, if we see, because it's the low cost, we have taken the like brick as a wall material and the roofing as terracotta, and then flooring as the yellow oxide flooring. That is the like, before red oxide it was there, so we just wanted to go with the different colors, so yellow oxide. So the total cost of construction is coming to be nearly 56 lakhs 48,000.
And then is the walkthrough. Sound.
Presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, I do see that you have tied it all up together well. There is uniformity in form also. Like I always speak about composition, there is a composition on the site also. Just that I am not sure about your costing at all.
That must be for one house is 56 lakhs.
It's
consultation fees.
Well, cost was not asked. Low. It's too low.
Oh. You are calculating the amount of the brick walls.
Don't even get into.
Yeah. Thank
you. You do have good orientation, usage of hollow blocks and all is in place. Can you just tell me your number? What is your competition number?
1147.
Okay, as you have seen the other presentations also, I do see there were certain elements which you can enhance. You could pick up from the others. There are other architects who are going to be giving you those. So I'm just going to pass the mic, but good job. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, a good attempt.
Yeah.
But I very much see certain shortages in certain aspects. If you can look into the planning process, you can open up the slide where you have the overall master plan. You have interesting open spaces meant for public usage, but it very much falls short when it comes near the residential units or the living or the housing units. Suddenly it becomes a total gridiron pattern, and the variety and the aspect of having the leisurely space gets lost, especially in the central spine in the two residential blocks. You have a gridiron pattern, and probably they should have had more pockets of openness, by the virtue of which it would have been much, much more leisurely. You know, you have given it in the extreme ends, okay, that is fine. But in between these pockets, they are drab.
Sir, we have designed it in this way because we are collecting rainwater. So we are going to keep
irrespective, that doesn't suffice to your whatever thing. And the other thing is the aspect of usage of material. It is low cost, fine. Then there is the aspect of maintenance. And for old age, when you are getting to have these walls built, even inside you have exposed brickwork, and the type of weather and so many things, you will have a lot of cobwebs and so many things which get in. It becomes very dusty, and maintenance is a big problem. And these old age people are susceptible to all sort of bronchitis or all sort of health issues related to breathing and things like that. So probably we have to be a little bit careful while addressing to these things. You know, probably externally fine, but internally you have to see to that how easily it can be maintained. Then the aspect of your open air theater and the Buddha and things like that, they could have been placed, they could have been really played in a much more interesting manner. You have just try to place that Buddha element in the forefront. How well it could have been reconnected inside the plaza. And
actually, inside the plaza, we played with the Nataraj Lord Shiva.
I mean to say, there are other pursuits where you have a library, you have so many things where you could have had it in a very interesting format.
Yes. The main theme is the uniformity, sir. Like, which we followed is the main thing is the uniformity. And then we want to gather everyone together and then celebrate their life. So, in the they're coming up the last days. We don't want anyone to have their own, like, because every individual unit has given their own space, and then the toilets inside, everything is there. But all of them together have to celebrate their life. That is what the main theme which we followed. So that is how the design came up with.
Fine, that's it.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, so overall, good job done.
Yeah, thank
but
you.
What I felt missing was the, you said it, the concept is village, the connecting to the roots.
Yeah.
That is not there. I did my thesis on Tata Cancer Hospital, which is also in Rajaghat.
Yeah.
When I talked to Bengalis there, they were like, so they love, you know, sitting together, having chai together, having whatever together, right? So you cannot force them to come to one common place and now celebrate. That's your way of looking at it,
yeah,
right? So when you talk about bringing that village, the roots, what do you think? That felt very missing there.
Actually, even we have visited the Tata Medical Center for the thesis topic, which we have done the case study, ma'am. But here, we are not forcing them. The
like
space
we have given separate spaces.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, when you choose a particular area, okay, so you have to understand. understand the cultural context there.
Okay.
So what I'm saying is that is the cultural context there. I'm
okay.
not saying
yeah,
like
yeah,
in
yeah, yeah.
They are like, right? Secondly, your residential area feels so clustered together that you do not feel that it's such a big site. If you have a site which is some 3 or 4 acres, you should feel that green space around, right? And you're talking about assisted living, so you want to make them feel inspired. Not you come outside, celebrate, and then move into your rooms where you do not have much light also. So the corridor that you're following, it's one long distance and very less light for the...
very narrow.
Yeah.
Lobby is not taken off, one or two blocks in the center, taken off. So then you will be interesting.
Exactly. And also your dining area is very far away for these people there. So that's on one corner. How about these? So every time they'll have to go there. Right?
We have provided
then
the kitchen
we have
area.
Actually we have provided a kitchen and a living inside. So
yeah.
It's depend on them like whether they want to go out
because,
or they can bring in and food.
But if I cannot cook and I cannot move also, so the administration people will have to restrict those people there. So they'll be restricted, no? They cannot put them here.
Yes, yes. Yeah. There are pros and cons, but yeah.
Your site planning is good.
Thank you.
Okay, as far as the site plan, it looks good. You have left the space for future development as well. Fine. But the development of site could have been more elaborate.
Yeah.
You could have looked into, and you should look into more what the people want. The senior citizens, they have special needs. They have different kind of problems. So each problem set needs to be handled in a different manner. You cannot have one size fits all policy. And what I see is that you have separated 15 residences for female, 15 for male.
Yeah.
So what about couples who will come in to live? What about, let's say, friends who want to...
That's live actually together? The units are designed for the, like, even the couple can be elaborated. So the corner units, which if the couples are coming, can be elaborated for them. That's what they thought about.
You have said that there were
different... the corner
areas, so
units.
That needs to be think of.
Yeah.
You have used all sorts of design concepts like amphitheater, courtyard, swimming pool, fountain, the Buddha, and the Nataraj as sculptural elements. But I don't see them connected in a way. The site plan looks really good, but the amphitheater shouldn't have been in the entrance of the entire design. You should have given the amphitheater where they're going to kind of culminate together, and then kind of the continuation will be a kind of a spillover area is an amphitheater. That sort of concept should be there. Secondly, I don't get the idea of having that sloping roof with those open rafters and ceiling fans. Now, if they are in an assisted living scenario, you don't want to run a risk of them getting cold or them getting rainwater sort of seeping out from the roof and all that. So have you thought about how will you kind of make those rooms weatherproof? Have you even thought about that?
Sir, but every time the roofs won't leak.
I would agree with her. My ancestral home is with, you know, that kind of even older terracotta tiles, you know. It doesn't leak.
Yes, I do understand.
Maintenance is a problem. Cobweb is a problem.
Maintenance aspect of it, I'm telling you, that if in the long run, you need to kind of, if somebody has to stay there for, say, five or six years, you need to have some sort of a durable material, but at the same time, think about some weather tightening or weatherproofing as well.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Interesting work, lot of work, efforts, but I believe that I can sell this proposal as a hotel or a resort also. Motel, yeah, motel, whatever the term could be. So the case is, again you see, you have very dense cottages near each other. Couple of them could have been removed and, see, I won't buy or would like to live in the cottage right in the center where everybody is looking at me and I'm not getting enough light and ventilation as others are getting. So yeah, privacy is definitely one of the issue. So again, I will go back to the first presentation that we had seen. As a student, we need to really let go whatever you have seen around and go beyond that and try to challenge your creativities. This is something that you must have seen somewhere, similar design, that Charbagh sort of plan and Mughal gardens and things like that. I believe as a student, our goal should be to think something that is not seen probably. So all the best, very good effort, and thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Actually, I'm not sure that in the beginning you have shown one local pond just nearby your site.
Yeah,
it's not used in your design.
This is the like the viewpoint towards the local pond, like which is this side of the site.
So only the visual impression.
It's not the only because that's what the only thing is what we are telling is the people like it's a assisted living center. The night they'll be sleeping, but it's not like everyone will be interacting all the times. Like we made the complete design as a barrier free, so it's like spending time with each other. And then getting olden days, it seems like they're used to that design before. Like giving something innovative is also good, but the thing is they should not get confused because of that. They came up with that, so we thought like it would be better we give what they want. So that is how we ended up giving.
So in the current proposal, I don't see that space. What you are saying,
yeah.
You know, you are saying proper. You are saying exactly right, but it is not being your design. So maybe you can use your local pond into all those spaces. You can convert those things. You know, that will help much better.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyways, it's good.
All right. Good.
Yeah. Thank you.
All the best.
Yeah. Thank you.
Keep your fingers crossed.